Minsan lang tayong dadaan sa mundong ito at sa ating pagdaan, gawin na natin ang tama dahil sa tama, kailanman, we will never go wrong. Maraming salamat po, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Dan Fernand. The next to deliver his opening remarks is another co-chair, the Chairman of the Committee on Human Rights, Congressman Benny Abante. You're recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Kala ko si Congressman Dan lang ang bibigay ng opening remarks. Anyway, to my fellow co-chairs and colleagues in the Quad Committee, our resource persons and guests, ang mga colleagues po dito, binabati ko rin po ang ating former president, GMA. Magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat. In the book of Proverbs, chapter 6, verse 27 and 28, we are asked, can a man take fire in his bosom and his clothes not be burned? Can one go upon hot coals and his feet not be burned? In our last three hearings, we have answered this question. The testimonies we have heard clearly illustrate the interconnectedness of wrongdoing, domino effects of sins, of how evil begets evil. Kaya akma po na magiging focus ng ating hearing ngayon ay pogo. Dahil dati, maraming nagsabi na hindi naman ito nakakasama. The gamblers are not Filipinos. Hindi mga kababayan natin ano kukurang. But as we have discovered, this is simply not true. We have learned that the impact of gambling does not stop with the individual gambler. The money earned from pogos, we have learned, supports and leads to other forms of wrongdoing, fraud, prostitution, money laundering, corruption, even torture and kidnapping. Hindi lamang yan. May testigo tayo, si Lieutenant Colonel Joby Espinito, who informed us that drug money was used to fund the quota system in the previous administration's war on drugs that resulted in thousands of deaths. Blinded by profit, for the love of money is the root of all evil. Those who were expected to uphold human rights ignored due process and committed injustices in the name of justice. After all that we have learned this Quad Committee, can anyone now say with a straight face that gambling is a harmless vice? Sana po, in the course of our hearings, we can all finally open our eyes to the fact that the evil of gambling extends far beyond personal sin. It is a societal evil, one that can corrupt our country and destroy lives. This interconnectedness of sin is why it is crucial for us to push forward in our hearings. We must recognize that even small acts of wrongdoing can have far-reaching consequences. Sin begets sin. Just as a single stone dropped into a pond creates ripples that spread far and wide. We cannot fool ourselves into thinking that these small illicit actions do not matter. My friends, we must recognize that we can only counter the seeds of sin by sowing the seeds of righteousness. I urge all our participants, all our resource persons, choose honesty over deceit, right over wrong, life over death. By doing so, we not only keep our nation from falling into the trap of sin, but we also create a ripple effect of goodness that can contribute to building the bagong Pilipinas we all aspire for. Let the axe fall where it should fall. Pagpapatuloy po namin itong hearing namin hanggat matapos po ito at tayo makagawa ng magandang batas upang once and for all, hinto na ang mga kalokohan dito sa ating bayan. Magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat.
Thank you, Bishop Congressman.